Meantime, South Australians will also spend tonight reflecting on the devastation caused by Ash Wednesday. As Brett Clappis reports, it's a date that is forever etched in the state's memory after the fire wreaked havoc through the Adelaide Hills and parts of the southeast.
South Australia's most devastating natural disaster. 28 lives lost, 1,500 people injured and more than 300 homes destroyed.
And then the wind changed and it just came right up here. Surrounded the house, went right up there, and then that house just blew right up the centre.
30 years on, the pain is still raw.
Evil. There's no other way of describing it.
Bruce Trenwith left his wife to defend their home while he joined his local fire brigade to help others.
The fire hit us there at the same time, and I'm crouched in the back of the unit like this, and I'm watching Owen, who's down here, and who's already passed out, I'm watching him through flame.
He believes post-traumatic stress has pushed the death toll even higher.
The number of people that died after Ash Wednesday from cancers in this street is just unbelievable. Just unbelievable. Oh, where's so-and-so? Cancer.
Fires spanned the state. The worst affected the Adelaide Hills and the state's southeast, where 2,000 square kilometres burned.
What's taken probably 30 years to build up has gone in one hour.
Unlike many, today John Clark talks freely about the haunting memories.
No, it's 30 years ago to me. I've heard people are still having nightmares. I don't have any nightmares about it.
Many will gather here at Mount Lofty Summit, which was all but raised back in 1983, to mark the 30th anniversary. A memorial service will pay tribute to the volunteer firefighters who lost their lives.
Including Andrew Lemke, whose family will pause to remember.
There's no point having that over your head all the time. You'll always be sad. So you've got to move on.
And hope Ash Wednesday is never relived. Brett Clappis, 10 News.